Romney and Ryan are united on the Republican ticket, but their visions for tax reform are different. The former governor, Mitt Romney, may cut the individual tax rates by 20%, drop the corporate tax rate to 25%, and eliminate the estate tax and alternative minimum tax. Paul Ryan wants to create a two-pronged structure, tax rates of 25% and 10%. Ryan also wants to eliminate the AMT, drop the corporate tax rate to 25%. For his take on the differences between the two men, what they mean for the election, I am joined right now by Republican strategist Jim Dyer. He served two presidents, Presidents Ronald Reagan and George H.W. Bush. Jim, welcome. Glad to have you with us. In political terms, how big are the differences between Romney and Ryan's points of view on taxes?
Well, Deirdre, it's nice to be with you. At this stage in the campaign, we probably don't have as much specificity as we will see as the election unfolds. The Ryan proposals were developed as he has been chairman of the Budget Committee, and they were developed as part of a Republican philosophy on the Hill to try to get the Congress and indeed the entire government looking not only at entitlement reform but at broad-based tax reform. They are very much a series of proposals which, as budget chairman, he would write, but then he would turn over for the details to the Ways and Means Committee, where others would take this on. Governor Romney's got proposals which have some likenesses and have some differences, but the reality is that Governor Romney is the candidate for president, so I believe at the end of the day, it will be the Romney proposals that most taxpayers and most voters will focus on.
Jim, I want to get back to that in a minute, but you started by saying there really isn't a lot of specificity. I mean, we gave some details, we gave some percentages, but it is kind of normal, right, at this point in the game. I mean, the Republican Party and the candidates can't really tip their hat too much, can't give too many details, right, about their plans, because then it becomes more about the election and the other side ripping apart those details, right?
Well, that's true. I would just make two other points, though. First, comprehensive tax reform is a tough one, which is why I don't expect it to be addressed until next year when we have another president and we have another Congress. The hardest part of comprehensive tax reform is the need to develop revenue neutrality to make sure that whatever your rate structure is, that you have offset it with follow-on tax preferences that can help pay for it. That's a very difficult thing to do, and I think that will be the challenge not only for the next president but for the next Congress. The other challenge you have, of course, is trying to find a level of common ground in the Congress between Republicans and Democrats, and in a roughly evenly divided Congress.
So, Jim, I'm really
and an evenly divided town, that's tough.
I was just going to say, I'm really glad you brought that point up. You've been in Washington, D.C. a long time. You served Presidents Reagan and Bush Sr. Do you feel like the tone in Washington is more aggressive and less helpful than it was when you were working closely on budgets?
I do, and it's unfortunate. I'm afraid that if you look at this Congress this year, you're going to see a number of items that really need to be addressed but have not been addressed because the political pressure not to do them has been greater than the pressure to do them. When you face a Congress that's coming to an end with the issue of sequester, which could cut another $200 billion out of the budget, and you couple that with the fact that the Bush tax cuts are going to expire on December 31st, you have two very major short-term issues that you have so far been unable to address. And really, before you got into comprehensive tax reform and comprehensive entitlement reform, you would need to address these issues and address them pretty quickly. So it promises to be a very difficult post-election session.
So, Jim, if you had to pick one piece of advice for anyone in Congress, what would you say now, given your years of experience?
Well, at some point in time here, the fighting has got to stop and there has got to be some kind of outreach. I think there's a lot of fear now that the outreach on either side will cost them votes and support among their base. But the truth of the matter is that neither political party has enough muscle to ram home its own proposals, and there's got to be some outreach and some conciliation If that has to take place after election, so be it, but it really has to happen.
It has to happen at some point. Jim, thanks so much for the time. Jim Dyer of the Podesta
Group. Nice to be with you.
Joining us this morning. Likewise, when we come back in the loop, we're going to get the Democrats' view of the Romney-Ryan ticket. Governor Jack Markell of Delaware will be joining us. We're going to talk with him about what it means for